again, when we were out looking at components on the machine, we talked about a chatter roller. Chatter is a natural occurrence in the wire drawing operation where you generate a harmonic vibration in the wire between the die and the draw block. You usually don't see it on the first blocks because the wire speed is slow enough that you have not reached that harmonic point yet. But as you move down the blocks with higher speed, you'll reach a point where that harmonic vibration starts and that wire will start to vibrate, and it creates a systematic pattern on the wire. If you look at the wire, you'll see a light spot, ring, a dark spot, a light spot, dark, light, dark, light, dark, right down the whole cast of the wire. If chatter is bad enough, you can actually run your fingers along the wire and you'll feel a harmonic wave in that wire. The only way to stop chatter in a wire is to lay something on the wire while it's running. Many people will just take a chain and lay a chain across the wire to stop that harmonic vibration. There's nothing wrong with using a chain, provided you keep your eye on the chain, because after the chain's been laying on the wire for a while, it'll get a groove in it. That groove will scratch the wire, or at least it'll rub the residual lubricant off the wire. And again, you're going to the next die where you've taken the lubrication off. A lot of people will use a roller. The more modern machines use a roller, and that's what we saw out on the machine that we're at today. It actually had a roller that ran on a little bearing that laid right on top of the wire. And you could adjust the pressure on that roller to offset that harmonic vibration. This is actually a chatter roller. This is the device that lays on the wire and creates the harmonic vibration of that wire from happening, which would control any chatter created by that harmonic movement. Again, this roller is important if we're going to lay it on the wire, that it turns freely and has no deep grooves or gouges in it. But again, the roller is only as good as the roller itself. If the roller has deep grooves in it, or if the roller isn't turning at all because the bearing's all gummed up, you've created more of a problem than you're trying to solve. So it's important to use some form of chatter reduction device, but you must remember, no matter what device you use, whether you lay a chain across the wire, whether you lay a wooden block across the wire, or you use the more modern chatter roller device, that device must be inspected so that it's smooth, and if it is turning, it turns. If it's just a dead weight, you have to make sure that you haven't left it on there long enough to create a deep groove within that dead weight, which will scratch or reduce the residual film on that wire.
Now let's review some key points from the video.